on the word of God, right? That's very important. It's not something that I made up. It's from the word of God, the Bible. We believe that the Bible is the word of God. God wrote this to us. It's a love letter to us. He wrote us so much. He wrote a letter. He loves us so much. What else does he have? Doctrines. There are three. There are three parts of the Trinity: the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And what else have you done? Last week we talked about Jesus and who Jesus is and where he came from. And now we're still talking about Jesus. Side can mean lots of different things. In ASL, it's the same way. Okay, right? Who wants to take this one? Dennis Frank, okay? Now, was unbalanced. You can move. Why are we emphasizing? option do we have? Go the other way. There's only one way. That's so limiting.
Oh, I am.
There's really only one. Oh, there's got to be another way. One way, that's it. Yes, there is only one way. There's one way. And I remember I had seen video clip of Oprah. You know who Oprah is? The black lady who's been famous on TV for many years. I remember she was talking her program. She said, I believe, and this is Oprah saying this, I believe there are many ways to heaven for God. There are many ways to God. Writing to different audiences. Paul is writing to who? preaching the law, circumcision, must be circumcised. And Paul's saying, no, that's not the way. Grace is the only way to be saved. James is writing to you. To Jews. Jews who for many years thought that they were already saved and they didn't have to do anything. And now, their old traditions and things that they've done, they say, now I can just sit back and do nothing. And James is saying, no, that's not true. Once you're saved, I'm looking for you to work. And if you're not working, I have a suspicion that you're not even saved. So Paul has one audience, James has another audience. And they're side by side. They're talking to different people with different goals. So it's important to know who they're writing to and why. That's why when I emphasize that when I'm starting a new book, I say, who wrote it and why? This is important. You read one verse and take it out of context and say, look, it says this. That's dangerous.
No.
Like this, because I'm a troublemaker.
I'm done.
Ryan, look up.
Ryan, take a minute. I
Father.
Number one. Who wants to brew? Okay.
Oh!
Now, just tell me the answer to what Bercher said.
Who met?
Kim. Do you want to start? What's her seven? Her strength is 15-7. Make a mistake, don't worry, I won't let you. I'll encourage you. Just like with my son, right? I encourage him. Jesus appeared after his resurrection in Mark chapter 16, verse 9. Mary Magdalene.
Hello.
Who was Mary
Magdalene?
No. No, she. She was the one who had 8 demons in her. Jesus cast out, right? And Luke chapter 24, verse 13. 15 and 18. Cleopas and in the same town.
Emma. Emma. I don't know who.
You don't know this person's name?
Emma.
Two guys, right? Sunday, right? Not Saturday, Saturday, but on Sunday. Cleopas and Dude. I'm calling him Dude, I guess. This guy, we're walking along. And they're walking along from Jerusalem to Emmaus. And so they're walking, and then another guy shows up. And they talk to him as they walk along. The guy said, you know who Jesus is? And they answered, yeah. So they were talking about, and the guy said, you know who rose again? And they said, no, we didn't know that. So they sat down and ate together, and suddenly Jesus disappeared. And these two men looked at each other and said, that was him. Now, you guys were walking along. They were sad. So, and Jesus appeared and they were talking. He talked some to them. He didn't ignore them. Jesus was good at keeping himself as something to be a secret. He didn't really announce himself all the time. Who's that? Cephas. Who's Cephas? Peter. his Greek name this evening. The word means stone. Peter is the rock. Cephas is the Greek word. Means stone, but anyway. So Cephas and the 12. And the next one. Who has the next one? You got the right answer. That was seen by about 5,000? No. 500 of the brethren at one time. James and the others. So Paul wrote these in 1 Corinthians. He wrote these verses. Why was it important to write about who Jesus was seen by? Who saw Jesus after his resurrection? Why is this important? They were witnesses. Eyewitnesses. If one person said, I saw Jesus, you know, people today say, oh, I saw Elvis alive. I saw Elvis alive in the gas station. One person says, yes, another person says, oh, I saw Hitler alive in South America. He's still alive in South America. That's a myth. So, these are all people who saw Jesus, who are eyewitnesses. Some of them were still alive when Paul was writing this. He said, if you don't believe me, you can go ask the people yourself. They saw it. You can go ask them. This isn't something that I made up. There are eyewitnesses who touched Jesus, who felt his hands, who put their hands on his body. There's proof that Jesus rose again. Last of all, he showed himself to me. Who's me? Who wrote the book? Paul. Paul wrote First Corinthians. Paul said, he saw
Jesus. I'm going to go far on Sunday.
Yes and no. The question was, Paul says, and he writes that he saw Jesus himself. She's asking, that time that he saw Jesus, was that on the road to Damascus? And I answered, yes and no. Damascus is an interesting. Paul was walking to Damascus, and what happened? He was blinded. He fell on the ground. And the four people who were with him said, what's wrong? They didn't see anything. He fell on the ground and he was talking. A voice called, Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me? It is hard to kick against the bricks. And he said, who are you, Lord? He knew who it was. Who are you, Lord? That's funny to me. But he said, I'm the one that you persecuted. And 3 days later, change happened later. Saul was blinded and put in jail a few times. No, not jail. He was blinded and he was led into this house. Not a jail, it was the house of Ananias. He showed up and said, the Lord sent me here. So Ananias healed his eyes. closely, like the 12, not who were constantly with him, like the 12, but for other disciples, people who believed. Altogether, probably 500. And later,